G'day and welcome back to Buildsome, and in this, the fourth video on AS1684.2, the timber framing code, I just wanted to go over something called the floor load width, or the FLW, and how we work that out. So as you can see here, the floor load width is the contributory width of floor measured horizontally, then imparts floor loads to a supporting member, namely the bearer. Floor load width shall be used as an input into the span tables in the supplements for all bearers and lower storey wall framing members. So we need to be able to work it out. So what we have to do is we have to work out the floor load width for all our different load bearing scenarios. So in this case we've got four different piers, and then whichever one works out to be higher, that's the one we're going to use for all of our calculations. So we'll go through and have a look at these four different scenarios. So, Pier 1, the load that Pier 1 is carrying is really only half the distance between Pier A and Pier B, because half of this load is being carried by Pier B. So, to work out the floor load width for A is half of this span, span 1, or span 1 divided by 2. So that'll give us the floor load width for that scenario there. For pier B, or bearer B, it's now going to be carrying half of this floor on this side and half of the floor on this side. So in this case it's this span plus this span divided by 2 to get half of each. That'll give us the floor load width for B. C is going to be pretty much the same situation. It's carrying half of this load and half of this load. So it's span 2 plus span 3 divided by 2. And then in the case of D, because this is a cantilever, it's going to be carrying all of this and half of the span back here. So for D, it's span 3 divided by 2 plus whatever the cantilever is, span 4. So there you go, that's how we work out the floor load width, and it is required as an input into our span tables so we can get the right size bearer for the situation that we've got.